Rapkind.
Yeah, man, look. Hey, I'm about to make a table. Okay. That I'm a wheel on stage. What I'm gonna do? Cause see, in jail, we just we used to fold our mattress back.
Right.
And niggas just bored and just start laying down, just beating, and that shit just got good. But that was that thin steel plate.
Yes, yes. And it vibrated.
That was welded. Now I paid attention to it. Now them welds was about some of them about this much apart. Okay. Boom, boom. That got a lot to do with the sound. Okay. And when you're hitting that bass, the closer you get to a corner, the tighter that bass get. It's just like a drum machine. That's real talk. Okay. I mean, set a corner right here. That motherfucker, boom, 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 boom. Swear to God. So that was entertaining to me. Yeah. And I got out that motherfucker wearing niggas' asses out. You know what I mean?
Let me ask you this. How important is it for artists to have that skill in today's rap world to you?
Man, it's very important. It's very important. I mean, come on, man. Here we are. We're in the internet age, man. Motherfucker and Justin Bieber, they weigh overnight. Yeah. But everybody don't got that talent.
Right.
So I tell nigga, man, save your music, man.
That's right.
You know what I mean? Right. And man, you know, loving it to me, man, just ain't enough no more.
Yeah, that's right.
You know what I'm saying? You gotta have like a real passion for that shit. You know? And I'm at the age now. I remember I didn't play with it, partied with it. First I was glad I even fucking made it. And I knew myself that I was gonna have to be something outstanding. Something that's remarkable, mm-hmm. Some undeniable
right.
shit.
Right.
And again, them same faces that told me no, and I wasn't even the one who asked them. Okay. You know, it was the homie them, but I still wanted to listen. But two motherfuckers turned me down, talking about I rap too fast and shit. Them same motherfuckers. We the best of friends now. They learned something in life, man. That's real talk.
That's real talk.
Yeah, man. No matter who you are, you know. Hey man, let's talk about Sack though, man, for a minute, man.
Sugafree, your style and your music will never ever play out. You feel me?
And that's a part of it.
Yeah.
That's a part of it. You know, I have to know beforehand, while I got this pencil on my hand, what can I say that's gonna make a mother pull over?
Yeah.
And say, what this nigga say? Okay. I search all day, every day for that. That's interesting to me. Because I used to be in jail all the time, prisons and YAs. You know, I was a YA up there and Mariposa down there.
Hey, yeah. Just having you on Rapkind is beautiful. And I'm going to let everybody else get their time with you, okay, too. Man. Bobby D presents Uncle Snoop's Army, Rapkind TV. Let's go.
I'm still your friendly neighborhood player partner, Sugafree, at Rapkind TV. Come on, man. SAC 916, Sacramento River. I can go on and on about Oak Park. Man, I can go. Mozzy, man, I keep going, man. Y'all that I mean. I love all y'all, man. Man, if it wasn't nobody else left in the world to pimp, I'd probably end up pimping me, man. You know what I'm saying? I love y'all, man.
Hey, Sugafree in the building, man. Let's go.
Hey, Bubbalicious the pimp.
Oh, yeah. Holla at Bub.
Hey, Bub, wait a minute now.
Wait a
minute. Wait a minute. Hey, Bubbalicious the one who told me, America. Bub the one who told me one day he woke up and he fell, when he was a baby, he fell into a box of glitter. And his mama told him ever since then, he been shining like a motherfucker. Woo! That nigga's a pimp, man. What's up, bub?